Hi guys, today I want to talk about sword grips evolution. Let's start with the Italian grip. We start with the Renaissance or late Renaissance cut and thrust sword. This weapon has a ricasso in which you can put one or two fingers, depending on the sword. And maximizes your ability to control the point, but also to control the edges, actually. This is a very comfortable grip for a cut and thrust weapon. From this one derives the rapier grip, which has the same logic. Now you will usually put two fingers in the ricasso to maximize point control. But this weapon is again a cut and thrust weapon, primarily fought for thrusting. It still requires you to have edges control. The strength of the grip is given by the three fingers holding the ricasso, thumb, index, and middle finger. You find the same logic in the Italian spadino and foil. Again, it's the three top fingers that hold the weapon and help you controlling fine motions. However, at some point, a new weapon was invented. The ones I'm showing you are not working reproductions, unable to shoot. Okay? This weapon is the pistol. The first pistols had a very acute angle grip, a simple grip with an acute angle. Why? They were single shots, so there weren't problems of recoil control. You had only one or two shots at best. And they were thought for instinctive pointing, which means you have to be able to accurately point them from shoulder height. You shot from the shoulder, not from the eyes. If I bring this weapon to the eyes, I have to hyperextend the wrist. But this weapon was not primarily meant for aimed fire. It was primarily meant for instinctive shooting. So, either from here, here, or here, this weapon maximizes the pointability from shoulder level, looking at the barrel from above. Why I'm telling you this? Because, in my opinion, the French dueling rapier grip is son of the old pistols. It has the same characteristics. You hold it in the same way. And it maximizes instinctive pointing from here or from here. At shoulder level, looking from above. It is not the most solid grip available, but is the one that, in my opinion, maximizes instinctive pointing. Later on, a new type of grip was born, and it's known as the pistol grip. Why so? It is some, in my opinion, of the later pistols, that ones that were made for aimed fire, so you see that the pistol has sights, and had the necessity to fire repeatedly, because they could fire more than one shot. So this new type of grip maximizes the strength and the ergonomic of the grip itself without too much effort, and so it is a very strong grip, a natural grip. However, it does not maximize the pointability from the shoulder. If I want to accurately point this weapon, I have to bring it to eye level and aim. If I point it from here, I may be on target, or maybe I'm not on target, I'm not as sure, because the angle of the grip changed. And this is more, more adapt to aiming from eye level. However, what it does, it gives me recoil resistance, natural handling qualities that the older grip didn't have, to the cost of the effectiveness of instinctive pointing from the shoulder. So, in my opinion, this new grip with the back strap is the mother of the modern sport fencing grip. Whereas the French grip is son of the older pistol grip, and the Italian grip is son of the rapier and sidesword grip. Thanks for watching.